Ooh, hello there, my fellow miners and crafters. GoodTimesWithScar here, and welcome back to the wonderful worlds of LOLcraft. That is right, we're here in the throne room, and we've got a lot of lols all around us here, but we're gonna have the last lol in the end, and we're gonna turn this back into the throne today, and it's gonna look super fancy. But in today's episode, we're also going to be going deep into the core of the Hermitcraft world, because in our last episode, of course, we built our massive, definitely not evil laser here, sucking the sun's rays into its power to create this massive laser, and I thought I was gonna die there, and I didn't, and I'm quite proud of myself. Oh, but I love flying through the cloud that the laser creates. It just looks super, super cool. And it would also be amazing if we made some kind of water stream that goes up and down the laser so that we can easily traverse the giant hull. But anyway, inside of our cave, part of Operation Strip Mine, we need to clean this place up. It's looking a little rough, so maybe we can make it a rail line. But the main challenge is for today is to set up the markers for where the TNT machines are gonna go. Now, I've got some plans for today. I think you're gonna be surprised, and I think you're gonna love it. But first, gotta clean this place up. It is looking a little bit rough. And now, we've got ourselves a rail line to take us from the drill all the way to the mine shafts. Now, I've marked out each one according to the probability of hitting the Mycelium Resistance. So this right here is right on the coastline and eventually ends up kind of where Decked Out is. So the probability of that actually being a location of the Mycelium Resistance is fairly low, but I think that area should eventually still be excavated, and the same with this one. But as we continue down the shaft here, we'll hit a orange and a red, because now we're starting to end up like right where the greenhouse is, according to at least the beacon placements. And then bam, that goes right over the iron shop. And then that goes over Ren shop. And then this kind of comes in around the chest monster, kind of where B-Dubs' shop is. So with that, we should cover a huge swath of territory. Problem is, everything I've tried in terms of redstone has failed, so we need to enlist somebody. We need some help from somebody that can help us do the boom boom. I think we got our man here, the myth, the legend, the Mumbo himself, and his mechanical redstone mustache will be the perfect candidate to help us find the Resistance headquarters with some mining machines here at his redstone shop. And boy, I didn't even know this place existed until a few minutes ago, or maybe I knew about it and I forgot, who knows. But this place is amazing. It's got these clever Minecraft names like Colvador, that's right. And this is a Colvador right here too, looking super fancy. Now this might be my favorite, this one. This is, what is this one? Papa Ute Trapanu. That's right, that's a Papa Ute Trapanu. And I actually might buy this for something, the Vatin Hiss. This is really useful for creating like one bubble stream that can do two things, which is amazing. But anyway, we need to contact Mumbo, see if he's willing to make us this machine. And please remember, this is all fun and games, and we're all best of friends. So don't take anything too serious from today's episode. And I also had a thought here. What if the entrance to the Resistance base is inside this shop? I mean, it's full of redstone and doors and things. Maybe we'll push a couple buttons before we leave.
So Scar, whereabouts are we actually meeting? I mean, we've got the town hall, we've got the HEP headquarters, we've got the llama. We could go anywhere. I mean, it's up to you. You own all these places.
That is true. Just go to the giant evil, I mean, giant beautiful laser, the real beautiful one.
Wait, this enormous, when did this pop up? This has popped up very recently.
Oh yeah, I don't sleep.
Yeah, no, that's a given. I'm going to have to get a look at this from the moon. I'm genuinely going to have to look at this thing from the moon. This is ridiculously impressive looking.
It's environmentally friendly. You see the solar panel up the top?
Is it though?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I mean, is that all that is required? So if you... So this is a horrendous laser that seems to be just absolutely pummeling into the earth, mm-hmm, right?
Yeah.
No one knows what that's doing to the air around the laser, I'm assuming, right? But the fact that it's solar powered makes it all right.
Yep, it's all perfect. It's all good. Certified, really. Certified, perfect.
All right, that's how it works.
Yeah, that's the Hermitcraft seal. Certified, perfect.
Certified, perfect. Brilliant. All right, where do we go? Do we go in there? Is this Or do we stay just on the edge of it?
You see, this is the problem with my builds. Is they're a lot like a Apple product. They're very aesthetically pleasing, but functionally, you know, they got some problems. So we just we just have to drop.
Okay. Now that you've cheesed off every single one of well, at least 50% of the viewers. Fantastic. Brilliant. Thank you.
I have an iPhone. Hey, you know, from the first 500 of my videos were recorded on a Mac.
Were they?
Yeah.
Oh, that's funny. So were mine. Oh. How interesting. We're in the same squad.
That's true. We're Mac bros. So I made this rail line, and it goes deep into the heart of Hermitcraft, right? And that is where I believe the resistance base lies. And I need your help, Mumbo, to like build some kind of machine to bore it out, because I've been strip mining. And I'm kind of tired of it.
I can totally understand that. That totally makes sense to me. Okay, well.
All right, well, I'll get in this one. And I marked out the... Oh, shoot. I actually haven't ridden this yet. Oh, no.
I mean, I can't really see. It feels like I'm being repeatedly knocked on the head by a lantern.
I just finished this. Oh, this is really distracting.
This is distracting. I feel like I can't hold a conversation.
If you look towards the wall, it's way more bearable.
Okay, I've crashed into you. Okay, we're at the end.
I'm not a redstoner. I did the best I could.
Well, that was enjoyable. Okay, so we've got this.
This is the little marking, right? So I made the probability of hitting somewhere in the middle of the shopping district based on like yellow, orange, and red. So as we go further up, it just gets to be like orange and then red. So if we maybe want to start somewhere like right here, so like this one, and then there's two reds and then an orange and a yellow afterwards.
So we're going for the heart of the shopping district, right? So you're thinking the red ones are like high likelihood.
They are going to bring us like right in the center of the shopping district, like straight in the middle. And then the orange one right there, that's kind of like off to the side. And there's another orange one right there. And that's kind of off to the side.
So we're going to do some precision tunneling, are we? Like we're getting redstone involved. Are we doing some machine? Look, you're gathering your redstone. Look, we're ready to go.
Yep, there you go.
This should be all we need.
What do we need to do this?
My experience with tunnel bores, I haven't really built them, but from what I remember, they're a little bit expensive. In fact, I feel a bit bad because this is the first project that you've tasked me with. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
And I hate to come in requesting some big budgets, you know, because there's nothing worse, you know, first project, well, hey, welcome to the team, and then you present a budget.
How much are we spending on these things?
I mean, they require 3 ancient debris each.
Oh, okay. Let's see about that. Let's check my wallet. We're good.
Why do you have so much stuff?
Well, I'm trying to get a whole bunch of hose.
Okay, cool. Well, why? Also, why is it in a brown box? Oh, is it? It's because of a leather wallet. Okay, I see. Okay, I'm part of the one brain cell squad. That's what I'm currently referring to as. All right, it takes my one brain cell a little while to actually warm up.
So I gave the task, the greatest task of HEP, to find the mycelium resistance base to the one brain cell. Oh, no.
to the one brain cell squad. Yes, indeed. I've got something to show you. If we hop down, all right, not only do I have the tunnel bores to show you, which is probably the more exciting thing.
Yeah.
But if you ride this minecart, right, but you go into F5 mode, you just repeatedly zoom into your own face.
Okay, I gotta see this.
So you have to be
this.
Looking in line. Yeah.
Oh, okay,
yeah.
Hold on. The button's gonna work here. We got this. Oh, I forgot. You have to push W. You gotta push W. I'm going so slow.
Oh my goodness sake, it's just terrible, Scar.
Oh yeah, you just face plant every one of them.
Well, I'm stuck in a lantern. This is just awful. I can't believe this. Obviously, we're heading over to the tunnel bores. You're probably there already because it took me about 14 days to actually get started. But I'll show you how to use them because they're not too complicated. Albeit, I don't know if you're aware of how tunnel bores kind of work.
No.
How fast are you expecting it to be? Because I suddenly realized, you know, you said you were bored of strip mining. You know, what are you thinking here?
Oh, I just thought you just push a button and it just goes, woo.
Okay.
Well, you do it with me.
We've lost our ride home.
Mistakes were made.
Okay, well, look, I'll show you roughly the maximum speed. You ready?
Yeah, I'm ready. Hit me with it.
Okay.
Whoa. Oh, so it's like so, super slow.
I mean, yes.
It's cool, but it's really slow.
It's really slow, dude. I mean, you're clearing a lot of area. Don't get me wrong. Like, you're clearing, we're finding a lot of stuff. Look, we got some lapis there and everything like that. But as far as like, we're trying to go forwards, it's as slow as it gets.
Do you think, okay, which is worse, my minecart or how slow this is?
I don't know, mate, but all I know is we're not doing so well today.
You know what we're going to do? We're going to make this into a competition.
All right.
I stand here, you stand on another, maybe we get another HEP member, and we basically race to see who finds the base first or whatever lava pocket we reach first.
I mean, that is actually a really funny idea. Just the slowest race of all time using tunnel wall machines. I like it. I like it. I like it. I like it. Okay.
Now we just need to find someone. Ooh. Ooh.
Are you getting the dings? The dings on the forehead.
Ow.
Have you tried going into F5 yet?
Yes. My face. I'm seeing flashes of my big smile.
Yeah. Ow. Here he comes.
Ow. Ouch.
Oh, it looks even more painful from another perspective.
Oh, yeah. Every one of those smashing that face.
It's like a weird Pac-Man, to be fair. He actually looks like a strange Pac-Man. He's like eating the glowing balls.
Who made that?
Mumbo.
Mumbo, you made that.
Mm-hmm. Yep. It certainly was not me.
Certainly not. No, you would have, of course, thought. Give some headroom.
My bad on that one. B-dubs,
yeah.
Welcome to Operation Gopher. Is that what we're calling it now? Or Strip Mine or Seek and Destroy? One of those. We've been mining out down here looking for the Resistance headquarters. Unsuccessfully, Mumbo comes in here with redstone. Boom, boom, to be precise. And
oh, good.
We've got a bit of a competition. So he made each one of these machines, right? And there's enough for each one of us to race either to a lava pocket or... Wait, that... Oh.
it's a bit of a laggy one.
Yeah.
Or resistance
oh
base.
Oh my.
So.
Hey!
Are you up for this?
I'm up for this. It's kind of like a ghost. It's a ghost TNT. I like it. Even more stealthy.
What do we have? How many? Oh, wow. You made a bunch of these things. So, B-dubs, like, you can take that one and then careful
okay.
The lava stream. Mumbo, this one.
I guess. I mean, so wait. How much faith? So orange, and then there's two reds up here. Who's going to count us in? I mean, they're a little bit far apart. I guess, yeah, you guys grab the reds.
Okay. I guess I'll grab the one at the end here. Give us the call, Mumbo.
All right. 3, 2, 1, go. This is going to be the worst. This might be one of those ideas that was really good in our heads.
All right, well.
Oh, Mumbo, I can hear yours going off, though. I can hear you're a little ahead of me. And our goal, we're looking for, what? We're getting resources here?
No, we're looking for the headquarters, dude.
Yes, right, okay. So one to find it, too. That'd be a good prize.
Yeah, do we have a prize? I have a prize. Whoever finds it gets the diamond ore.
Ooh, okay.
Well, that's, I mean, as far as I was expecting like a jokey prize, that's like an actual prize.
That's a fine prize. Yeah.
I could build a minecart rail in your base.
This could go on for ages.
Yeah, we might. That's a good point, Scott. How confident are you that you are, that these are actually lined up roughly with where you think the headquarters is?
We're just trusting Scar's madness.
I have done a bit of mapping. I did have a bit of an accident here. I'm going to have to do some changes.
Wait, have you broken
it lagged
well?
Out a little bit, but I think I'm good. I think I'm good now. Okay. So I made a map and I've mined out everywhere else. So, I mean, there can't really be anywhere else unless they built this somewhere else.
Right.
Okay.
Unless they built it somewhere else.
That is my scientific reasoning is that, you know, they might have built it somewhere else or they built it in the vicinity of these tracks because there legitimately is nowhere else in the shopping district at this point. And I think I'm broken here. Oh, shoot. Oh, no.
Are you? Do you want me to come fix you up?
I could use a little assistance, please.
What have you done?
I don't know.
Okay, you managed to somehow compress your whole flying machine. I don't know if that's caused by... I feel like we could be dealing with a tiny...
He's compacted the design. Yeah. It's compact now.
Hey, I make unintentional mob farms and I make unintentional compact redstone devices.
Wow.
Yeah.
This fantastic.
Pretty good, right, Bean?
This is
yeah.
I think Mumbo's pretty impressed with my redstone and my mining skills.
I think he is too. He's saying bizarre, skills, that but is. I think he really likes it.
I'm impressed by what you've managed to achieve. The race is back on.
Okay. The race is back on. All right. Once
How
you guys
have
are in place, let me know.
For? I think we've
been a good 40 minutes.
Yeah, it feels like it. I've aged.
Have we discussed what will we do if we find it?
Wow, I didn't really think of that.
We're not that far into the planning yet.
It's all about the race at the minute, to be honest with you, B-dubs.
Okay. Yeah.
Yeah.
There's a lot of diamonds on the line there, B-dubs.
Yeah, that's true. I'm just going to say, if there's any crops, I'm trampling them.
And the Mycelium Resistance is construct a podium for this wonderful race that we're currently on.
Boys?
Yeah?
Yeah?
Boys!
What?
I see concrete!
That's it. That's...
Ah!
I'm coming.
I see crops.
Just trample
them. You see them. Crops? Where have you gone?
I'm going to trample them.
Trample.
I told you.
Wait.
Oh, you did.
Are you
the
real one? Are you actually in?
This feels like the fake one that we pre-trampled.
Wait, hang on. Let me go over there. That's my resignation there.
Your what?
Oh, it is? Oh, we're so happy you did it, by the way.
Let's see. Dear members of the Resistance, I joined as the leader as I saw members of HEP had... Wait, we didn't mistreat...
You don't have to read that. You don't have to read it.
Well, this is awkward, isn't it?
This HEP mistreated a vault, and I was informed that in the Resistance, you believe in treating...
Should we just get back to the race? Remember the race.
All right. Well, before you guys go, make sure you get a chair just because, you know.
Oh, right.
Yeah, get yourself a chair for your base.
They're nice chairs.
They are nice chairs. These machines are working. They're a little slow, that is. They're like a mule or a donkey of the redstone world.
Yes.
But reliable.
Donkey of the redstone world. Yeah, well, I'm gradually making progress anyway.
Scar, could you say mule again?
No.
Well, the good news is, guys, is that this might be the first episode of the official Hermitcraft podcast. Just make sure if you see anything that even remotely resembles decked out, you turn off that machine and start running the opposite direction.
Oh, right.
No,
right.
That is the one thing I've done is I've been very, very careful on anything under the shopping district that we could destroy like decked out.
Okay.
That's why this tunnel is so like cockeyed. Dude, I was finding ancient hermit builds that never showed up in anyone's video in my last episode.
I can see Grian's name tag. What? So I think you might be on towards something.
Dude. Really?
Yeah. I can see Grian's name tag, but he's now shifting.
Are you sure? I didn't see it.
I didn't hallucinate it, I don't think.
Are we going under any shops or anything? Or No, we're
way underground. He was underneath it. He was under it.
Under the machine?
So we go... Yeah, are we going...
Oh, come on, machine.
What level have we built this?
I don't know, actually.
We're too high.
We've gone over the headquarters.
We're just...
Well, Scar, you've
surface.
Officially led us to the fake base again.
Look. Can you see? He's running around.
Oh, keep pushing. Keep pushing. Should
but
I come over?
Fast.
Yeah, come over.
Nice and slow. Yeah, come over.
Okay.
Oh, dude, we're on it. We're coming in.
He's panicking.
We're on it.
You're on it?
That's good. Keep going.
I see Ren.
You do?
One more time.
I'm going to remove the ancient debris. I'm going to start launching TNT in.
We're in.
We should have discussed plans. Why
dude,
are we talking
I've got
about
no
the race?
Idea what to do now.
I'm taking the chairs.
You're taking the chairs?
Yes. These are very
just
nice chairs.
TNT in.
Dude, I have no idea. I really did think we were going to make it, and I didn't plan after the machines part.
Nice. Hey, and if they run, we could hit the emergency meeting button and force them back.
Yeah, that's how that works. Come on, spam it.
Okay,
spam
here we go.
Button.
Come on back.
I think they already used it.
Oh, they already used it. Okay. Okay.
Whereabouts is their vault? Oh, did we?
Oh,
wait a minute.
Oh,
guys.
No. Oh, no. Uh-oh.
Is it fake again?
It's okay, Mumbo. We'll make you a special vault somewhere.
We came in through the vault.
Oh, we came in through the vault? Uh-oh.
Yeah, we came in through the vault. I specifically removed stuff from the flying machine so that I would blow up more stuff. I'm not on the vault.
Oh.
The vault is basically
there is a chest here.
Dead. Look, it's like a little face. Look, it's a dead face.
Oh, that's a heartbreak. Well, let's trample some crops then, shall we?
That's a great idea. That's basically our only plan.
Well, I mean, this is alone is worth it, I feel like.
Did we win?
I think we won.
Oh, good job, guys. The real turf war on this server is not between mycelium or grass. No, it is between this chair and me and Jelly. One of us will win this. What in the world? Oh, Grian, hi. I want to see the entrance to the base. Yes, I definitely. Wait, no, it's supposed to be haha, not maha. My microphone's covering the keyboard. I would love to.
Grian? There he is.
Where are you? I found the local transportation. Goodbye.
No, get off. No, get off.
Oh, hello.
First of all,
I'm not even gonna ask. Never mind. Yes.
Yeah. So I'll do a little bit of a backtrack. I'll explain what's going on because I need some explanations from you straight away.
Yeah.
I want to know first and foremost, how did you find our base? Who messed up? How did you find out?
Oh no! It was my brilliance.
What do you mean?
From all my strip mining.
Oh, you didn't know where the base was at all.
Oh no. No, you didn't know? I've been strip mining the entire shopping district.
Huh.
Yeah, and then I got enlisted the help of Sir Odia here, and he made me these little boring machines finally, because, dude.
I saw you, yeah, I saw Mumbo there, and I was super confused. Okay.
He's on our team now.
How long have you been strip mining under the shopping district?
Almost 2 weeks.
Is that what the laser is?
Oh yeah, the definitely not evil laser, yeah.
I said that earlier. I was like, this looks so evil. Okay. Right. I thought someone had given away the coordinates somehow or messed up by showing the entrance. No, you just did it by trial and error, systematically made your way.
Oh my gosh, dude. It's just nice to be out of those caves. I'll be honest with you. Also, I found ancient Hermitcraft builds that nobody ever put in their videos under there. I have seen some weird things down in the bowels of the shopping district.
Well, okay. First of all, congratulations. Point to HEP. You discovered the base.
Our first point.
And we are now baseless. The whole team is baseless. So, you know, actually the only thing that the base was good for was being secret. And now that it's not secret, you know, you can have it. It's yours. It's your base now. You can HEPify it, turn it into a HEP storage unit. I don't care. It's ruined. But do you want to see where the entrance has been this whole time?
Well, can I just give you one of my guesses?
Yeah, go on.
I walked into Odia over here and I pushed and pulled every lever there possibly could because I just figured being Mumbo
it's
the
not in Odia.
Head of the
it's
resistance.
It's not in Odia.
Dude,
not even close.
I did everything. I did them all. I turned everything.
I've never been in here.
Hmm?
I've never been in here.
Oh, it's wonderful. But yeah, no, I pushed every lever, so it's not here, right?
No, not at all. Not even close. How do we get out?
The shop. I don't remember.
It's here. It was here the whole time. It's right here under stress monster's tree. The reason stress accidentally found our base and joined the resistance is because the entrance is literally right here. You open this shulker box and you fall in.
I saw this and thought it was like her extra storage one day. And I was like, well, that's peculiar. This holds. Okay, well, apparently it's scar proof, dude. I
stand on top of it. There we go.
Dude, that was literally scar proof.
This is the real base. And it was there the whole time. And, you know, people had actually figured out where we were because of bedrock and stuff. But we just, like, pretended like they didn't.
For the, I think it's now 205 emails that I've received on the base locations, I haven't read any of them. So everyone who sent it, I appreciate it, but I did not want to get spoiled. But I do appreciate you taking the time.
That's why we also don't watch each other's videos as well, because it spoils too much.
Oh, sorry about
that. Wait, I actually want to go and have a look at this.
Look at the dead face, right?
Oh, dude, that looks like something out of a movie. That is amazing.
Right? Okay, so also, somehow this boring machine got lined up absolutely perfect. So it went straight down the middle of this place.
To the block.
Dude.
Nicely
it's
done.
My unintentional and brilliance, right?
So wait, this is where you've been strip mine. Oh, bro, you have been strip mining.
There's also a lot of these boreholes and other areas. Everywhere basically has been strip mined.
Okay, well, yeah, you know. Right, so congratulations. You've got yourself one resistance headquarters. This is all yours now.
Two, technically. We found the fake one.
You found the fake one as well. Okay, so my audience don't actually know this, but hilariously, the fake base is literally right next to this one.
All right, well then, we'll see you in the fields.
Mm-hmm. You won't need to look for this one, because it'll just be out there.
Oh, really? Well, then I'll be looking forward to seeing it. All right, goodbye, Mother Spore. Goodbye, have a great day.
Goodbye.
Well, that was an episode to remember for sure, and I had no idea that was going to turn out as well as it did. Now, I didn't quite realize that our friends over in the Mycelium Resistance, well, when they escaped, they blanketed the entire shopping district again with mycelium, and this must be the mycelium that they were able to secure from the factory that didn't blow up. So while we were jumping for joy and trampling some crops, well, they got one on us. They got the area entirely covered with mycelium, and yeah, so we're gonna have to deal with this in our next episode, but I'm really excited to see what they do for their base. As Grian said, they are planning something above ground. So yeah, I am quite excited for that. But until next time, this has been Good Times with Scar, and I always really appreciate you guys taking the time to watch the videos. And if you believe the videos are rating, that would be much appreciated. And until next time, we'll see you later. And don't forget to subscribe, because you may just become scarred for life.